Hey guys, what's up? Ombarus here and welcome to another episode. In this week, I thought I'd talk a little bit about my experience in how I became a game programmer. Because you see, normally I'd be talking about my development of my own game. But this week, I've been mostly fixing a whole bunch of bugs. I mean, a whole huge list. But it's kind of boring, there's not much to talk about. So I thought this week, let's make a video about how you can become a game programmer if you're interested in this kind of stuff. First of all, a disclaimer. My personal experience is probably not representative of how you become a game programmer in general. Also, I'm from Canada, so my experience is very much Canadian. If you're from America or Europe, maybe the way to do it is different. But hopefully there's some similarities and you can learn something from my personal experience. So it all started about maybe 15 years ago when I decided I wanted to go to university. I did get a technical degree in computer science before deciding to go to university, but I thought I needed some more stronger foundation to be able to maybe become a game programmer or something like that. I mean, it's always been in the back of my mind, you know. I wanted something more than doing web development or being a full stack developer or something like that. You have to remember that 15 years ago, software engineering was just a budding new program. The university I got into, actually, I was the second class to ever attend this program. Before that, if you wanted to be into software engineering or something like that, you had to take electrical engineering. But nowadays, there's so much more classes you can take. I mean, there wasn't any video game development classes when I started, but nowadays there are. In university, you can take video game specific development classes, and you can take, deep machine learning classes and stuff like that. This didn't exist 15 years ago, but I did choose all the options that could lead to video game development. So I took image processing classes and computer graphics classes and these kind of things that I knew would help me go towards what I wanted to accomplish in software development. But even after 4 years of university, I didn't think it would be enough to get me a dream job. I needed some experience or maybe some personal awesome project to showcase, to stand out of the crowd of resume that piles up on people's desks. But instead, I found a job in Japan, and maybe when I think about it, it was actually harder than finding a job in the video game industries, but I guess I got lucky. I had a few contacts, and I worked for a company that made websites for Japanese mobile market, so it wasn't exactly related, or it wasn't my dream job, but the experience was absolutely amazing, and the experience in the mobile market is actually kind of related to how I got my job when I came back to Canada. And so it was actually a really good experience. After 3 years working in Japan, I decided it was time to come back. And when I came back to Canada, I was pretty confident that 3 years of experience in Japan, some basic Japanese language proficiency, and a university degree would be enough to at least get me some kind of interview in a video game company. So I applied for all the video games company I could find, and it turned out that not the experience in Japan, but the experience with the Japanese mobile market just 9 years ago when the smartphone market was exploding was really a big plus. And so I got myself a job in the mobile video game industry. From there, I got to work on a whole bunch of titles from, you know, basic casual games to really hardcore game on the mobile. I got incredibly a lot of experience because since mobile is maybe a little bit smaller, like the teams are a little bit smaller, you know, there isn't like 1,000 employee or 1,000 programmer working on the game. It's only like a dozen programmer maybe on a single title. Well, it means that you get to do a lot of stuff. So I've touched pretty much everything. When you work in a game company, it's very common to work a whole bunch of titles that are never going to see the light of day. I've heard that companies like Supercell from Clash of Clans and King from Candy Crush actually produce like dozens of prototypes before one of those prototypes ends up being released and becoming an actual game. You don't hear much about these prototypes. Sometimes they become public beta, but sometimes they don't even get out of the company. But there's people working on these things. And so even though I don't have that many titles I've released in the last 9 years, I worked on a whole bunch of titles that were prototyped, abandoned, gave up, canceled, whatever. But, you know, they still provided me with a lot of experience. And really, all you need is to get some experience. It doesn't matter where, but if you manage to get in the video game industry, after that, I think it's fairly easy to move from one game studio to another. Because from my experience, looking at my coworker who've quit to go to another game studio or change job or something like that, after 2 years working at my previous company, I started getting offers and recruitments and people coming to me, and I'm pretty sure it would be fairly easy if I wanted to find another job in a game company. And I'm kind of lucky because in Montreal, where I'm from, there's like 20 different game companies. It's really a mecca of game companies, and it really helps if you're looking for a job, right? Because they're all competing against each other to get like the most talented people, which means they are also hiring a lot of new blood, and you have a good chance to find a job as long as you have a little something to make you stand out from the crowd. If you want to find a job in the video game industry, the advice I could give you is maybe try to get out of like, hey, look, I made a prototype of a platformer in Unity, and try to find something a little bit more original. Maybe you can get some skills that are related to video games, but not directly connected. So like me getting experience in the mobile market to get a job in a mobile video game company, even though what I was doing was web development, it kind of helped me. I think these kind of things that stand out a little bit more, even because nowadays everyone is told to have a portfolio, right? So everyone has a few projects when they apply for a job, if they're anywhere serious about getting a job. But if your portfolio contains some a little bit different things, maybe some machine learning or maybe some data analysis or something like that, I think this will get you a better chance of finding your dream job. So that's about it for today, guys. Thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. And see you guys in my next episode. Bye!